for God's children, God permits what he hates to achieve what he loves. Now, I'm not saying that tritely or easily or quickly or as a throwaway cliche phrase. I'm saying that as a rock that needs to get put under your feet, or you will sink in the sinking sand of life. Part and parcel of God's love for us will include pain and suffering. The comfort for believers is that we can know adversity and pain will never come to us by accident or by way of fate or as a result of an independent evil one working against us, but rather they will come to us as divine gifts and means of grace, as an expression of God's perfect, purifying, sanctifying love. God isn't a fortune teller or a soothsayer or a mere predictor with a crystal ball. He knows what's coming, friends, because he plans what's coming. There are some here this morning, I know for a fact, your life has gone to hell in a handbasket. Everything is falling apart economically, personally, relationally, familially, and I'm saying it might be that God's sovereign hand is working things in your life so that you might be for the first time ready to listen and hear the word of God. Before you were stubborn, prideful, arrogant, full of yourself, cocky, confident. Now you've been wounded, brought low, and you are needy. And that's God's mercy to you. You're going to respond in faith. And if you're here in Christ, God's word to you is this: be comforted, loved one. Even when you cannot see my hand, it's there. And sometimes I permit what I hate to achieve what I love. Stay in the story. I'm not done writing it yet.